Hey guys, this is Ben with HotDogCartStore.com and LearnHotDogs.com and the Street Food Pro Team. There's the hat. Look at that. Love that sexy hat. Anyway, we are going to talk today about starting without a cart because people ask me, can you start without a cart? How do I get started? How do I start vending without a cart? You feel like, oh, I gotta, you know, it's like a lot of people, entrepreneurs especially, we a lot of us tend to be type A personalities. And we think, oh my gosh, I really need to have everything in line before I get started. You know, like if you're going to start a heating and air company, you want a nice van and have it vinyl and graphics on the side. And no, don't let these small problems, these problems that don't prevent you from having money, okay? They don't prevent you from having money. Don't let those problems prevent you from making money today. I've got some questions to answer too, so if you're here and you know you asked questions, I'll be answering them, so don't worry. And then if you've got other questions, just put them in the comments below. Heather's down there watching for me. She's sick right now, so wish her well. She's all drunked up on some NyQuil right now and trying to hold together the fort. So we've been creating, one of the questions before I start this, I'm going to tell you this. We've been creating these ebooks, and today I'm going to give you a brand new ebook that we created for you. It's brand new, it's free. Now later, a lot of you go, well, the ebook's gone. Okay, I watched this video a week later and the ebook's gone, and I apologize. Okay, because these ebooks come out of the Street Food Pro team. It comes out of the private group, and they're not available. We're like doing a bonus. We're giving them away for a limited time and then they're gone, okay? So you can try them out, check them out, see what you think. Thanks for all the hearts and thumbs. I like all that good stuff. Now, here's what you have to do though. You have to think about this as you go, because you don't want to go, well, I can't start vending. I can't afford a cart. Well, y'all know me, I was bankrupt. Bankrupt food stamps. I was on food stamps and started. Now, I did start with a cart, but I didn't let the cart stop me from starting, okay? I got a crappy cart. I'm talking a $400 or $500 piece of crap, POS, they call it. I'm not even going to tell you what that stands for, but most of you probably know. So, I was like, what do I do? How do I get started? But over the years, I've learned all kinds of tricks because I've met some cool, innovative vendors who started with literally nothing. Nothing. And so you can. And I've got in this ebook a story with photos of a guy that starts with almost nothing. You're going to get to see his story, his pictures, how he started and how much he made. You're going to blow your mind without a cart. So you don't have to have a hot dog cart or a catering cart or a vending cart all fancy schmancied up with vinyl graphics and 17 swooper flags and t-shirts already made and business cards already made to get started. No, get started. Don't wait to get started. Don't come up with reasons why you can't start. Get started. Then you'll make it, period. You'll make it. If you have that kind of will and that kind of drive, you're going to make it, period. So there is a way to start without a cart. There's about 5 different ways to start without a cart. Okay, there's all kinds of secrets. You can, there's so much stuff that you can do to start vending in your town without a cart. Let me give you just one example, one tip, one thing, real quick, okay? Did you know my neighboring state, North Carolina, you can go over there and get you a pot with grease in it, set up on the side of the road, and make funnel cakes legally without a health department license. Don't dare sell a hot dog, though, because you have to have a license for that. But my point is, did you just start vending with a pot and some grease and a flame? Yeah. So you might have $40 invested, and now you're good to go? Well, how many days do you need to do that? Not many. Not many. I mean, literally, when I started vending, my wife was by my side. We were broke as convicts broke, and I only could afford, I think it was 2 packs of hot dogs. It may have been 1, okay? And I had the hot dogs, and as soon as I started selling, what did my wife have to do? She had to take the money we just took in, run down to the grocery store, get me a couple more packs of hot dogs, and I was ready to go, and I was selling hot dogs. And we did that for 3 days. 3 days, We bought hot dogs as we sold them. Now, each day we got to buy a little bit more, so it meant less trips to the store. But don't ever let anything stop you. Ever. Because this isn't like, I want to be an astronaut. And you know how everybody tells you growing up, oh, you can be anything you want to be? Well, BS. Okay, you can't be anything you want to be. I want to be an astrophysicist. But you can't with an IQ of a plant. So I'm not going to be an astrophysicist. But, and I can't be, you know, an astronaut. A lot of people want to be astronauts, aren't never going to be astronauts. The point is, can you be a successful 100 grand a year, 8,000 your first month like I did, hot dog vendor, street food vendor? Can you? Absolutely. I know a lady that just started. She emailed me. Well, she didn't just start, but she emailed me today. Okay, today. She started selling just snacks, stuff she didn't have to have a commissary for, pre-wrapped snacks. She started selling. And now she has her own restaurant in a mall and a food truck. How do you get better than that? That's somebody that didn't let situations and circumstances prevent her from following a goal. Now, I understand you may be going, well, I don't know if I want to vend the rest of my life. You don't have to vend the rest of your life. Maybe this is a stepping stone to the next thing. Maybe this is the stepping stone that gets you to the next thing you want to do. For me, it's been the saving grace. That's why my book is called Hot Dog Saved My Life, is because it freaking saved my life. It allowed me to feed my kids. So you have to look at that stuff. You don't have to do this slow. You know, there's vendors that, you know, I hear from vendors that make $50,000 a year or $30,000 a year, and they go, what do I need to do? And I do these private consults sometimes with them, and they, because they want immediate help. I never encourage private consults, okay? Don't waste your money. Just freaking look at the blog. There's so much there. You'll learn everything you need to know. But I do private consults, and some of them, they'll go, well, I'm making $12,000. I just don't know what to do. And I can show them just a few tweaks, and all of a sudden they're making more, period. There is no ands, ifs, and buts. Y'all have heard me, if you've heard me over the last week or two, I talked about the ABCs of this, about digging a hole. This is dig a hole type stuff. You can do this. I want you to do this. It makes my day when I get messages like I got this morning from the lady that started just selling snacks, pre-wrapped snacks. That stuff is inspiring. Now, I want you to know, today I'm giving away this ebook. It won't be around for weeks, okay? It'll be around for a couple, 3 days. And then once it's gone, it's gone. It's in the members area, but it's not on the Facebook page anymore. You click the link and it's, nope, it's not there. So, grab that today. Grab it today and download it. It's free, okay? It doesn't cost a thing. It's instant. It's boop, boop. If you can click some buttons, you can have it. And you can thank Heather for the cool design, because she kicks butt on freaking that stuff. Now, some people wrote in, and Heather sent me a message and said, you got to cover this today. People are asking about how to win this free cart. We give away a cart every year, have for 7 years, 7 or 8 years, maybe eight. We've been giving away a cart. And this year, we decided to give away the cart to a group member. Somebody who's taking this serious, who's going, yeah, I'm going to do this. I want to learn as much as I can. I'm going to invest in myself. And you're talking, if you opt for the yearly plan, it's less than 50 cents a day. Otherwise, it's less than a dollar a day. But you can get in the members group and have full access instantly to all kinds of stuff. I mean, all kinds of stuff. But if you get in the Street Food Pro Vendors United group, okay, and maybe Heather will put up a link. Either way, even if she doesn't, when you get the ebook, it's gonna tell you the link. So you'll see the link either way. She's gonna put up the link to the ebook, and here in a minute, it's learnhotdogs.com/ebook. That's pretty easy. learnhotdogs.com/ebook. You can have it free right now. If you can click a button, you can have it. So that's how you win the cart. That's the only way to win the cart. And you don't sign up for it or anything. If you're a member, doesn't matter if you've been a member for 5 days or you're a member for a year, we don't track that part of it. All we do is we take all the members that are eligible. I think it's about 86 days away. Let me move a message out of my way here. 86 days away, I think, It's December 1st, whenever that is, December 1st, we're going to give away a cart live. And I may do it right here on Facebook. That way everybody can see it. And they'll see the winner because I'll invite them in. Or I may do a Skype call or something, but I'll broadcast it live either way. Okay, Tamika just asked, and let me double check. Heather, you may need to, if you get any questions that I need to answer, you may need to put them on Skype because I'm not seeing all of them here. I only see what two things at a time, so it doesn't tell me. But Tamika Scott asked, how can I become a vendor when the state I live in, Georgia, does not accept hot dog carts? Well, I can tell you this. They do accept hot dog carts. There's no code against hot dog carts in the state of Georgia. I have over 250 customers of mine. Now, that doesn't count all the other manufacturers of mine in the state of Georgia. So here's what you can do, because you will hear BS, okay? You will hear BS from time to time from dumb people, okay? So I think it was Tamika that just asked that question. I can't see it anymore. But Tamika, what I would do is go to learnhotdogs.com/ and this liar, L-I-A-R. Read that article, and it'll tell you exactly what to do when you hear something that sounds wonky. There is not a state in this nation that restricts hot dog carts or restricts food vending. So I know we're having signal problems. I think we're getting wacky-do things in the air from this hurricane or storm going across the country. But let's see. Question. Adam says, I got a cart and my license just need a good location. Having a lot of trouble finding a good spot. Well, go to learnhotdogs.com, Adam, and type in the word location. Location. Okay? And you're going to notice something at the top of that page right below where the search box is on the right-hand side. Learnhotdogs.com, right-hand side. Search box says, just search. Type in the word location and look how many things I've done on location and how to get locations. But also, you're going to notice the number one question, the number one problem that has plagued vendors forever has been location, and I solved it. And I want you to watch the video that's right below the search box. I have one there for you. Watch that. That's going to change everything for you. In fact, I got an email today. Let me see if I can find this real quick. Bear with me. Don't get all uppity. Okay, here it is right here. I saved these in testimonials. This is today, okay? And I want you to hear this. Ben, I just wanted to say thank you. ... I have been working locations that I couldn't get before. Short story, about a year ago, I tried to get into a car dealership, and believe me, it was a grind and never heard back from them. And then he capitalizes, never. Now, with your location hack, all the same doors that were closed are now open. More and more are coming. The courthouse, the county paper shredding day, and I'm waiting for the okay on the tax DMV building right now. Okay? That's from Charlie this morning. That was 3:43 a.m. I don't know where Charlie lives, but hopefully he wasn't up watching Oprah at reruns at 3:43 a.m. But that's when I got that email today. 3:43 this morning. That's it says on my time zone. So, can you do it? Tamika, you're so welcome. You're welcome. Kenny says, I have a question. I'm meeting with my city's Department of Transportation manager. I'm hoping to be approved to have exclusive rights to vend there. Absolutely. It never hurts to ask. But what I was just saying, what that vendor was talking about, my location hack, any location hack, I'm talking any location you want, you can get that hack. You'll see it, learnhotdogs.com, right-hand side. You'll see it near the top of the page on the right-hand side. It's always there. In fact, I just put it there about 3 weeks ago. We used to never offer it. I only did it on private consults. I only taught the information. Do you suggest being closer to the road or right in the bus hub? I suggest being closer to wherever there's walking traffic. Now, can you make money with stopping traffic? You know, people driving by, and you got to stop them. That's fine as long as it's easy to get in and out. But most people, you'll relate to this, most people, when they go somewhere, they want to go from point A to point B. They don't want to stop in between at A.5, okay? They want to go. So even though they may even be hungry, they may go, ah, I'll stop later or whatever. So it's harder to stop traffic. I never suggest getting a location where you're trying to stop traffic. The best locations in the world are the ones where there's people walking. Always there. They're a captive audience. Okay, so I would say stay closer to the bus hub. People standing around waiting on the bus. People doing stuff. People walking in and out of the Tractor Supply store. If you want a list of the top 100 locations, I'll create one for you, okay? And I'll make an ebook for you. Heather, if you can write a tickler note or something on that, because I won't remember in 2 seconds. Then I'll help you get locations. But if you search locations, you can find a blue million of them locations at learnhotdogs.com and then type in locations in the search box. Or cut to the chase, skip it all. Invest in yourself and get my location hack. You'll never have to worry about it again, ever. I mean, you'll get instant yeses. Yes, 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 yeah. Oh, I want to be at the front of the police station. Sure, come on in. You don't believe me? Try. I've got over 1,000 vendors. 1,000, and that's over 1,000. There's over 15,000 customers of ours, but about 1,000 that I either taught that or have bought it in the last 6 weeks that I started offering that course. And about 800 have bought it in the last 6 weeks. And all of them, every single one of them that I know of, have emailed me and told me, Ben, I cannot believe I just got the courthouse. I cannot believe I just got in front of Walmart and don't have to pay a dime. You wouldn't believe the stuff that's available to you. Question, Thomas Thompson with building my own car, is it mandatory to have a stainless steel top? Absolutely not. Okay? FDA Chapter 4, NSF, or I hate saying NSF because that's a private company. ANSI Standard 59, which is the actual standard. Okay? Says as long as it is a non-porous food safe top. So you could polyurethane a plywood board and make it non-porous, which means it doesn't have holes, and now you have a food safe top as long as you use a chemical that's safe for that. But I'll tell you this, polyurethane is safe for that because it's approved in all 50 states. Go into a Sonny's, a barbecue place, a lot of restaurants that have bars, it's all polyurethane. You can serve food on that. Yes. So, absolutely. You don't have to have stainless steel at all. Stainless steel just makes it easy to clean, and it's prettier, and it just looks better, maybe. But if y'all have seen my Build-A-Cart course, you've seen that cart. We actually gave that cart away live and took pictures with the winner and all that stuff. That cart is all wood. And look how pretty it was. Now, later, we upgraded it and put the stainless steel on top of it just to sexy it up. But you don't have to ever do that. Heck no. Non-porous surfaces. That's what FDA says, and that's what ANSI standard is. ANSI standard isn't even a standard, really. I mean, it's just made up by a company called NSF. FDA is the one that matters, and that's Chapter 4. Chapter 4 of the FDA food standards says that it has to be a non-porous, food-safe material. Polyurethane. There's several of them. Plastic. You just can't have a lot of holes in it where bacteria can grow. You can't do that. It's got to be easily smooth, cleanable surface. That's why a lot of people use stainless. Now, just to tell you real quick, stainless is not expensive for a small piece. So you could do a small area, your prep area, in stainless for $100, $120, something like that. 304 grade, which is the best grade for food, and it's what the standard is. Doesn't have to be, but that's what the standard is. Chris asks, what's a good price to pay for monthly commissary rentals? I teach a course on how to make money with commissaries, and so it depends on who you ask. I've got vendors right now, and you've heard them, Jason Brown, who rent commissary space, okay? You've heard Jason on the radio. He rents out his commissary. He built his own and designed it, and he used it for himself, but then he started renting it to other vendors. You can make a lot of money doing that. So I've got a friend that's all he does now is just a commissary. He makes enough money off of vendors with a commissary, he quit vending. And he charges $350 a month, okay? He's right across the mountain from me, which is a good price because they put in, a lot of them put in all kinds of equipment so you can make stuff and do stuff. So stoves and you name it. So that's where we are there. I would say that I teach you in my book, okay? You can download my book right now. I don't know if that link's going to go up today, but if not, message us on here and we'll get you the link. But I would say, go to learnhotdogs.com/book/book, and that'll get you the book. You can download it. And that way you don't have to wait on it to ship or anything like that. Now, what was I saying? Oh, I teach you how to not pay for commissaries. I don't like paying for them. So even though I have a course on how to make money with commissaries, I still teach both sides. My goal isn't just to go, oh, I'm going to make, I'm trying to help everybody. And as you grow, you'll get better and you'll go, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and do my own commissary. I did eventually. And then you start renting it and then you start making money. That's how I learned that stuff. So there's lots of money to be made there, but you can also get commissaries for free. I show you how. I never paid for a commissary, ever. So yes, you can get them free. Okay, let's see. Any other questions? I don't see any other questions. And I promised, you know what? There's about 20 people live right now. If you're listening live, okay, I want you to put a thumbs up or a happy face or something, but in the comments. Because what I'm going to do is we're going to pick one person and I'm going to send you free a set of chip clips. Okay, those are the hanging chip clips, not the short, dinky, crappy ones you get from other places. I'm talking the 31-inch long, commercial, heavy-duty chip clips, absolutely free. One person's going to win it. All you have to do is make a comment below, just a thumbs up or something. I'll have Heather do some kind of picking out of somebody and put it in my Skype so, because I can't see the comments. I can only see two at a time, so I see that Manny has commented, Melanie's commented. You're going to win. Somebody's going to win a set of chip clips plus shipping. I'm going to ship it to you. There's no cost, no catch. All I'm going to ask you to do is when we're done is, I'll tell you what all you have to do. You just have to email me. So we'll wait, give everybody a time to pull up your stuff real quick. I'm going to take a sip of coffee. I love coffee. Didn't start drinking coffee till about 6 years ago. So there we go. So we've got a lot of people posting. I'm going to give you more time. Don't do it twice or anything. You don't have to. She's just going to pick somebody, and then we're going to send a set of chip clips out to you absolutely free. That's two of them, okay? Double hung, double-sided chip clips, not the cheap version, commercial version, okay? That we sell on our store. So you can go look at how much they are. And I'm going to send them to you for free. Because I thank you for listening. Because I like people who take this serious, take every opportunity they can to learn. And I understand if you're slinging dogs, you can't be watching me. Okay, but if you're slinging dogs, you probably don't need to be watching me. So we're going to send out that. And then we'll pick a winner, and then I'll be back on Sunday night. If you look down the page or maybe up the page, we have the live show that we do every month. You gotta register for it, but it's free. You just register for it. I do it every month. Been doing it for 7 or 8 years. It's the Hot Dog Vendor Radio Show and Street Food Vendor TV live. You can ask questions. You can watch. You can call in and listen. You can listen on your computer. You can listen on your Android, your tablet. Doesn't matter. You can probably even, if you live close enough to me, we'll hook up a can with string and we can talk to each other that way. Random.org generator is how we selected the winner. You can go to random.org generator. The winner is Chris Kinney. Chris Kinney, you win. And here's all you got to do is email support at She'll put the email right in here for you. support@vendorsunited.com. And I need your do it like this, though. Don't make this hard for me. Put your name, address, just like you would filling out an envelope, and a phone number, because they often ask for a phone number. I won't call you, okay? So just put that on there, and then I'm going to mail this out to you, okay? I'll get this mailed maybe tomorrow, but it'll probably be Monday. You'll probably see it Wednesday or Thursday. But Chris Kenny, congratulations. You won the Chip Clips. Thank y'all for listening. I love you. I hope you have a fantastic weekend. I will be back this weekend, Sunday night and Monday. So even though there's a holiday, still be here. Love you guys, and I can't wait. If you have questions, more questions, be sure to use the little tab somewhere on this page. This says Ask Ben or Talk to Ben, and you can actually leave a voicemail, and I'll freaking answer it. I get them instantly. Nobody screens them. I get them direct. I get my email screened, my text messenger screened. Those aren't screened. You can message me instantly. So, at least for the time being, because I don't get enough of them to be slammed. So you can message me there. I love you. See you later. Hope you're having a good weekend. Stay safe if you're in a bad area for the flooding and all that crap. I've been hearing from vendors that are like crappy places, Tallahassee and Gainesville, Florida, and Georgia. I've had 3 vendors text me today from Georgia's bad storms. So y'all just take care of yourselves, take care of your family, then go back out there. Consider maybe operating your cart if there's a rescue situation and there's a lot of people. Sometimes people do that. If the power's out, they'll open their cart up and help people, like feed the firemen or feed the rescue crews or Red Cross or something. That may be a good thing. But I'll see y'all later, and we'll have more fun. Thank you. Congratulations again, Chris Kenny. Congratulations.